Have you faced some problems while providing the electrical isolation between two DC circuits? When a load is connected to a DC source, is operated from another DC source? In this video, you can get the solution. Hi friends, this is Ram Prasad and you are watching Circuit Lab. This channel contains the videos of different electrical and electronic circuits with simulation and hardware design. For more technical related videos, please subscribe to this channel. In this tutorial, the objectives are: what is optocoupler, working of optocoupler, how to isolate the DC circuits using optocoupler, design of a DC isolator circuit with simulation and hardware demonstration. The optocoupler is an electronic device which transfers the electrical signals in form of light waves to provide the electrical isolation between its coupled input and output circuits. That means it acts as a safety component which isolates to both input and output circuits by using light signals. The input circuit of the optocoupler is consist of an LED that produces the infrared light when the supply is given to it, and its output is a photosensitive semiconductor device called phototransistor, which detects the emitted infrared light beam and switches the secondary circuit without direct electrical contact from primary circuit. Both the photo LED and photo transistors are enclosed in a light tight body. The important function of optocoupler is to prevent the rapidly changing voltages or high voltages on one side of the circuit from distorting transmissions or damaging components on the another side of the circuit. Let us start the circuit simulation. This is multisim software. We need two separate DC source. From power source, it is DC power, source 1, 12 volt, and another source, 5 volt. Here, this is the optocoupler, this is the photodiode side, and this is phototransistor side. For switching the primary side, a switch is required. From basic, we can get the switch. You can also change the values, means you can disable the values according to your requirement. Now the value is disabled. Then we require two LEDs for two isolated circuits sides of the optocoupler, which are connected in series with the series resistors. We can change here the resistance values according to our requirement. I have taken here 100 ohm resistor for primary side and 550 ohm resistor for secondary side. Let us start the circuit connection. From source 1, the positive terminal of the 5 volt is connected in series with the switch, which is connected in series with series resistor and LED. The output of the LED is connected in series with the photodiode side. The remaining end of the photodiode side is connected to the negative terminal of the source 5 volt. Similar connection we can do from secondary source. The 5 volt source is connected in similar manner to the phototransistor side. To avoid simulation error, we have to ground it both the isolated sides. Now here, the primary side is completely electrically isolated from the secondary side. Let us start the simulation. When I simulate this, now the switch is off, so the photo diode is inactive. Now by energizing the primary side of the photodiode, the LED is also glowing and the secondary LED is also glowing. You can see by switching off, both the LED are being off. Here the photodiode provides electrical signals in form of light wave, which isolates this circuit, means this photodiode circuits, from phototransistor circuit. We can connect voltmeters to measure the voltage across each isolated circuits. Now it is connected in parallel to the circuit 1. Similar connection is for circuit 2. According to polarity, we have to connect the voltmeter. That means the positive terminal of the supply source is connected to positive end of the voltmeter and vice versa. When you simulate this, now by switching to the primary side, the voltage is coming approximately 5 volt, and the isolated secondary side is also depends on this primary side, which is 12 volt. Now 0 is showing both the sides because the primary side we have changed. So this is source 1, this is circuits of the source 2, and the source 2 is controlled by operating the source 1. By oscilloscope we can see the waveforms of both primary and secondary sides. The primary sides is connected to the channel A of the oscilloscope. The negative terminal of the oscilloscope is connected to negative terminal of the supply source, whereas the channel B is connected across the second load, that means the second circuit. When I simulate this, we can see the waveforms of both primary side, that means the channel A is connected to primary circuit, that means photodiode circuit, and the channel B is connected to phototransistor circuit, and these are the waveforms. If you switching this, we can see both the voltage being zero, approximately zero. By using grapher, we can trace the accurate waveform. This is grapher. When I simulate this, you can see the waveforms. By stopping the simulation, from cursor we can trace the voltage of channel A and B. You can see here. From here, this is the voltage of channel A, that is 5 volt when switch is being on, and this is the voltage of channel B, which is 11.9, it approximately 12 volt when switch is on. When I have off the switch, the voltage decreases to 0. So now this is the complete simulation of a opto isolator circuit, which isolates the primary circuit and secondary DC circuit when the secondary DC circuit is operated by controlling primary DC circuit. Let us start the hardware demonstration. Let us start the hardware demonstration of optocoupler circuit. Now this is the AC supply, which is connected to the input of the transformers, and the transformers electrically isolated from each other, and they are giving low voltage AC. They are decreasing the voltage from high voltage to low voltage, and this is the DC rectifier circuit, and this is for 12 volt, this is for 5 volt, and we are getting the output of DC supply, which are isolated from each other between these two terminals. These two terminals is for 5 volt, these two terminals is for 12 volt. I have explained more about
DC rectifier circuit in my first tutorial, you can refer. This is the hardware circuit of optocoupler. And this is the optocoupler MCT2E. The pin number 1 is the anode of photodiode. Pin number 2 is the cathode of photodiode. Pin number 3 is no connection. Pin number 4 is the photo transistor emitter. And the pin number 5 is the photo transistor collector. Pin number 6 is the photo transistor base. So here, two separate isolated supply sources are there. The two terminals is for 12 volt DC. This is positive of 12 volt DC. This is negative terminal of 12 volt DC. Similarly, these two terminals is for 5 volt DC. This is positive 5 volt and negative, that means ground of the 5 volt. Now from 5 volt, the positive wire, this is connected to the switch input. The switch is connected in series with the resistor. From here it is connected to resistor, then it is connected to LED, and it is connected to anode of the photodiode. And the cathode of the photodiode, it is connected to ground of the 5 volt. Similarly, in case of 12 volt, the positive terminal pin is connected to the collector of phototransistor. The pin number 5 is the collector pin, and from emitter, that means from emitter pin through series resistor and LED, the supply of ground is connected. So here the 5 volt and 12 volt both are isolated. By giving supply, you can see by switching this, by switching the 5 volt part, we can also switch the 12 volt. So here the optocoupler isolates 5 volt and 12 volt. Now there is no connection, there is no electrical connection from 5 volt to 12 volt. 12 volt is an isolated part, but 5 volt supply when we are giving to photo diode, inside this light packet, the light wave transmits, which switches the photo transistor, and the supply is connected through LED and series resistor, so the LED 2 is glowing. So this is complete hardware demonstration of optocoupler circuit. That means when a DC source is controlled electrically isolated from another DC source, we have to use an optocoupler. For more videos, please like, share and subscribe to our channel. Thank you very much.